Let's fast forward to 2006, the wild card game versus the Seahawks. It's one of the more infamous plays in NFL history, playoff history, to say the least. What was your vantage point and thought process during Tony Romo's fumble and the run towards the goal line?
Dude, you don't understand the magnitude of the playoffs. That's why we talk about it. People always ask, like, why y'all talk about the playoffs? Like, the playoffs. No, the playoffs are another level, bro. Like, it ain't no level. Yeah, it's a whole, I see all of us, like, man, that's different, man. Like,
everybody moving faster.
Everybody teams was way harder in the playoffs than they was in the regular season. But, man, you know, and for us, man, like, when we saw Romo fumble it, it still wasn't like this panic. Mm-hmm. We was like, all right, you know, and you see the edge, and you're like, he gonna get there. Like, he gonna get there. And then when he got tackled, bro, and you realize, like, and y'all know your season over so abruptly.
Yep, quick.
It's like, it's just over. It like, bro, like, we don't have another, like, we don't have another series or another possession. No, it's over. It's a wrap. So, man, it made me realize immediately, like, you know, do it. We played 21 growing up. Do or die got a different meaning when you play pro football. And when it happened, dude, we was like, dude, we Marshawn didn't go off. You know, we D'd him up. Like, he had,
that was a good game. Runs,
but he finished with like 70 yards. Like, that's a good day based on what he was doing. Yeah. And as we looked at it in totality, we're like, damn, we supposed to win this game. But y'all know, bro, like, the self-inflicted wounds cost you championships. They cost you playoff wins more than a team just lining straight up and beating you. You know, we get back to the film room and we like, man, look how bad I was on that technique. And I gave up a 20-yard run, or I gave up a pass, or I gave up, you know, but what made y'all good? Bouncing back. Problem with the playoffs, dog, your ass might not have a chance to bounce back until next year. It's
one and done.
So, yeah, man. So it was when I started to understand, like, the gravity of it and why people kept bringing it up, I was like, the playoffs. Like,
see, the thing about the playoffs, when plays like that happen, you don't know exactly what could have been if you guys took care of your business. Because all you got to do is just get to the next round. And that's the most important thing about the playoffs. You get into the tournament, anybody can win.
Yes.
Anybody can win. But when you lose like that, you're like, yo, man, we could have been in the ship, bro. We could have.
Dude, every reaction to every year I lost in the playoffs was, man, we the one that we done made it to the Super Bowl. That's always the reaction.
Going, but you always go back to 2006. Always.
Always, bro. And I remember the one year I actually felt like that for real when Chicago went to the playoffs. And we had beat them in the regular season. And we beat the Giants twice. I believe it was 07.
That's 07 team.
07. We beat them twice in the regular season.
But lost to them in the playoffs, right?
Oh, man. And Chicago went to the championship, bro. And we blasted the Bears earlier in that season. Now, obviously, we all know, we've been professionals long enough to know that all of that don't have carryover. But that was the first time I felt like, oh, we know who they are at least. And we know we can beat them.
You're not afraid of them. You actually want that matchup because you had success.
It was a mess, bro. And then Eli and them went and won the damn Super Bowl. And it just hurt all over the place.
Get in the tournament.
Hey, Spears, was that 017 the best team you were a part of? That Cowboys 017?
I think
you got either, the 13-3 that year.
That 13-3, that was T.O.
That was
Pat Crayton. That was Marion Barber. You know what, though?
Wasn't Roy on that team, too, right?
Jason was there. But I tell you, man, like, that was the best team because we was built so well in the trenches, bro. We had big Leonard Davis. Yeah. We had big Flozell Adams.
Man, Flozell might have been the biggest human I ever seen because when he came to Pittsburgh, man.
Flozell the hotel, bro. Like,
so you had to look up to him like this. What the freak is going on up there?
I got baptized a many days by that big fella when I was a rookie, bro.
Hey, Pat P, you talk about big human? Man, Flo had to be about 6'8". Strong and mean, too. Didn't want a joke. He was always serious.
He was like he was on a typewriter, bro.
Always
move. You look at him and you like, dude, it's no way you can move. And then he get out there, cat quick reflexes.
Yeah.
Like, right. Crazy. Crazy.